All right, guys, we have a lot to talk about. Let's start with fired White House aide Omarosa Menegalt Newman is now facing legal action from the Trump campaign, accusing her of violating a secrecy agreement. The campaign claims Menegalt Newman's explosive new book and media tour breached her 2016 confidentiality agreement with them. She also released several audio recordings, including one with the president, in which she said nobody told him that she'd been fired by Chief of Staff John Kelly. So, guys, what do you think about this controversy here? Any surprises, or is this more of the same, or what?
In some ways, she gets what she deserves, I think. You can tell she's an opportunist, has been even since the Apprentice days, and will do anything it takes. And she's even said that, you know, I have to watch myself. She was recording conversations. But then he comes out and tweets this ridiculous thing and lowers himself, and it's probably, I think, a low point. When you call somebody a dog and what you said, if a respectable CEO of a corporation did that to an employee, imagine the fallout. And, going after people like that or LeBron James or Meryl Streep, why lower yourself when you're the president of the United States?
Boy,
I forgot what
the
tweet was, but she made some comment about him and he attacks.
Right.
So, I think both sides, she deserves it and he should stop it.
Somebody should be the bigger person and hush.
There you go.
So, Danni, how do you see it?
I agree a lot with what Steve's saying. I think the violation of security is a scary thing, and I think that's in all realms of everything going on, from computers to meetings at the White House. It's hard. If it was somebody besides Omarosa, I may have a different opinion, and that's where it's, crying wolf. She's done this in so much in the past, but I do feel it's a... I'm kind of tired of the years and months that it takes for anything to come out. Whatever happened to yesterday, today?
Yeah.
If it happened and it's going on, then why does everyone wait, no matter what it is?
Mm-hmm. Right.
But I don't know what there is to say about it all.
I've never been a big fan of her brash, antagonistic type personality that she has. And I'm quite honest, and you guys can answer if you can. What was her job at the White House? What did she do?
That's a good question.
She dealt with minority affairs issues there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
But
a lot,
some critics will also say she learned a lot from President Trump, that they were actually almost two of a kind, according to some people.
Be interesting to see how her book does and how many people want to read it.
And I guess I didn't stay up close to it because I always thought they were close.
Well, she loved him 2 weeks ago. So now she's like,
All right, let's move on.
All right. Fake vomit claims by Uber drivers are apparently costing passengers big bucks. The West Michigan Better Business Bureau is warning customers to check their credit cards. They say some Uber drivers are finding pictures online or submitting photos that they create themselves to claim that a passenger made a mess in the car, all in order to get the cleanup money from the company. Uber says the vast majority of its drivers are legit, and so are most of the cleaning fee reports. Company says it does terminate agreements with drivers who don't follow the rules. So, are you a big Uber fan, Danni? And
I'm a big fan of the concept.
Do you check your credit card after if you use
yes.
it?
Yes. And we'll leave it just
so
it right
well,
there.
Yeah.
We know why Ubers pick us up. Bring the cabs back. I don't remember this ever happening with cabs. But then again, we didn't have social media like we do now and the technology.
Yeah.
There's always a few that mess it up for everyone.
True.
Because all Uber drivers don't
literally
do that. And all passengers don't throw up. But it's back to, I don't understand how people do this. Would you be able to sleep at night if you falsely? It's stealing from someone.
It is.
You
it
are
is.
Stealing That's, $150 from someone.
It is.
I've been in a number of lifts just the past couple of weeks because of a recent trip that I took, and all of the cars were just immaculate. And I'm not sure, because at the end, after you pay, you can rate the driver and do all. I wonder if these people are not giving them good reports, or him or her good reports, and maybe that's why they're doing it. I don't
is
know.
That way to
it's,
get back
it's wrong, bottom line, that's all there is to it.
All right, Steve.
I suppose, of all the stories in all the world, they picked the one about vomit in cars. I think now you get out of the Uber, you take a picture of where you sat, and then you keep that.
Hey, that's a good idea.
Yeah, I guess, right? You got to go to that length.
See, this is why, so that we could have consumer reporter Steve Conley.
And where do you find fake vomit?
Advice.
If you wanted to go and
it's
buy
online,
some,
I'm pretty sure.
Oh, is it? Okay. But all that just to get 150.
We'll get some for you.
All right. Well, we were all saddened this week to hear the reports, of course, about Aretha Franklin's failing health. A source close to her family says the 76-year-old Memphis native is in home hospice care after battling health problems for years. There's been an outpouring of support and prayers for her on social media, from everyday fans to big name celebrities like former President Bill Clinton, who asked people to lift Franklin up by listening and sharing her songs that have meant the most to you. So, Todd, what's your favorite Aretha Franklin song?
I don't know. I think that's the first song that everybody's probably going to think of. I'm going to defer here to Steve, because I have a feeling he could probably name 10 of those songs.
She truly, if not the greatest vocalist living today and possibly ever. The performance she did in the Blues Brothers movie, Think was just fantastic.
So classic.
And that version of it, which was just juiced up so good. The other one was, and it still gives me chills, I looked it up last night, put it on Facebook, was Natural Woman, when she played at the Carole King induction and the Kennedy Center thing. That was phenomenal. I mean, Obama is crying, she's freaking out, and Aretha nailed it.
All right.
Absolutely nailed it.
Danny.
Well, I have to agree with Todd, and even though it's an Otis Redding original, it's timeless. Everyone knows it. There's my parents knew it. There's a video of me singing it. I have a 2-year-old singing it. It will be around forever. So I think that's
love and prayers being sent her way.
A quick list here. I know you were waiting with George Michael. Respect.
Oh yeah.
I Say a Little Prayer. Think Chain of Fools. Let It Be. Son of a Preacher. Freeway of Love, just to name a few.
The freeway.
Thank you guys so much.
She's iconic. Great seeing you.
Thank you.
All right.
Good.